Are you married to an abusive, controlling, narcissistic spouse and you're trying to figure out how you can possibly leave? The first thing you have to do is to take precautions, but you have to be smart about it. By the end of this video, you'll know the smart way to get prepared. But first, please subscribe to my channel and hit the bell so you'll be notified when I post a new video every Friday. For those of you who don't know me, I'm Victoria Makui. I'm a transformation coach, a motivational speaker, and the creator of the Reclaim Your Power system. I've helped hundreds of women and a handful of men gain the knowledge, the strength, and the confidence to leave a narcissistic spouse and to go on and create a wonderful, meaningful new life that's joyful and drama-free. Okay, so let's talk about the smart way to prepare to leave a narcissistic spouse. The S in smart is for stash. Yep, you are going to need cash and you need to start stashing it wherever you can find it. So is that taking some cash back when you go to the grocery store? Is that getting a secret side hustle? Is that taking something out of a joint account that won't be noticed? I'm not sure what it is, but wherever you can earn, borrow the cash you're going to need to have consultations with lawyers that may cost a couple of $100s, up to $400 in some areas just for the consultation, hiring a coach, making investments in getting yourself ready. Those are going to take some money and you might not be able to put it on a credit card. You don't want to let the cat out of the bag. You want to take these precautions without the narcissist knowing that you're getting your ducks in a row. All right, so that is going to mean finding ways, maybe it's a secret credit card if that's possible, but find ways to be able to access funds that you can keep secret. M is for matter of fact. That is how you're going to relate to your narcissist in a totally matter of fact way. You're not going to let any emotion in and you're not going to give any emotion out. You're just going to communicate in a friendly, positive way, but you're not going to engage in any of the conflict. Yeah, I know it's hard, and you're not ready for gray rock yet because you don't want to make the narcissist suspicious that you're changing, you're getting your ducks in a row, you're taking these precautions, or that anything is different yet. So just do your best to let it bounce right off of you. Channel your inner Stepford wife, right? Pleasant, positive, but no emotion. A is for accounting. You're going to take an accounting of every asset, every account, every piece of income. You're going to be the financial detective. You're going to dig up whatever paperwork there is. 3 years of tax returns, 12 months of bank statements for every account there is. That's every checking account, every savings account, every investment account, every 401k, every loan, every car loan, everything, every bill, what it takes to run your household, every gas bill, light bill, utility bill, that was the word I was looking for, everything that you spend money on, tuition, clothes, food, entertainment, liquor, anything and everything, cable, cell phone, the list goes on and on. But you are going to do a deep dive into all of the accounting of every penny that comes in, every penny that goes out, and any accounts out there, loans you may have taken, personal loans, loans from family or friends, whatever, and get the documentation, as much paperwork as you can on this. If it's electronic, download it and make a copy, and you keep all of this secreted away in either hard copies in a safe deposit box, at a friend, I don't know, if you really trust the friend, or family, or in the cloud, a cloud that he has no access to. So that is your A for accounting. Before we get to the last two letters, I want to ask you a question. Are you starting to see how you have to change your mindset here? You have to get out of that victim mentality and you have to take charge. You have to take ownership of the work that needs to be done for you to successfully get out of this abusive marriage. So if this resonates with you, if you're starting to see the shift of stepping into that power, then do me a favor and in the comments, write boss, because you are becoming a boss at doing the work that needs to get done. All right, let's get back to the letters. R is for record. That means write everything down. Take notes every single day of what happened, right? So this is a journaling of everything he does, says, anything out of the ordinary, who did what that day. Get into the habit of writing down or typing into a document that you can keep in the cloud. Every day dated, what happened? Did you take one of the kids to the doctor? Did you go to the parent-teacher conference? Did he say that he was going to help with something and didn't show up? I don't know, whatever it is, wherever there is a parenting issue, and if there are no kids, then just a relationship issue, whatever it is. Did he make a large purchase without your consent? Did he move money around? Whatever it is, and you don't know what is important now, something that you don't think can help your case now might be just the thing later. So write everything down, record it. And finally, we have T, which is for train. You have to train as if you were an athlete. You are. You're running a marathon. This is not a sprint. This takes longer than you want to know. And you have to be in shape in every way, emotionally, physically, psychologically, spiritually, financially. You need to get into the best shape of your life in all of these areas so that you can go the distance and you can win your divorce from a narcissist. Okay, so now you know the smart way to prepare for divorcing a narcissist. If you would like more help and guidance from me, you can book a free strategy session. I'll put a link below where you can sign up for a time that works for you on my calendar and expect to spend 30 to 45 minutes with me. I'd love to hear what's going on in your life and how I might be able to help. I'm also putting a link in the description to a free gift that I would love to send you. It's called Divorcing a Narcissist, A Guide to Rethinking What Winning Means. This is a great tool for you to use in shifting the way you see the outcome of your divorce so that you can get through it with a lot less emotional damage. Thanks for watching. If you liked this video, will you give it a thumbs up and leave me a comment? I love hearing from you. Now, here are some other videos you might like to watch.